Dear second year students, your grammar exercise is on page 10 of your English book. I'll start with exercise 1. Name the parts of speech of each italicized word in the following sentences. And in each case, reason for the classification. Still waters run deep. After the storm comes the calm. He still lives in the house. The after effects of the drug are bad. The up train is late. It weighs about a pound. He told us all about the battle. He was only a yard off me. Suddenly one of the wheels came off. Muhammadans fast in the month of Ramzan. He kept the fast for a week. He is on the committee. Let us move on. Sit down and rest a while. I will watch while you sleep. They while away their evenings with books and games. Now in the first one, still waters run deep. Still water is here, it is noun. Khada pani, gehra hota hai. Number 2, he still lives in the house. Here still is a verb. Wo abhi bhi us ghar mein rehta hai. After the storm comes the calm. Now here after is a preposition. The after effects of the drugs are bad. Here after effects are noun. After the storm comes the calm. Isme ye noun and preposition dono mein use ho raha hai. The up train is late. The train that goes up. It weighs about a pound almost. Here it's an adjective. He told us all about the battle. Something that he explained. Here it is an adverb. He was only a yard off me. Off is a preposition over here. Only is explaining how much of a yard. Suddenly one of the wheels came off. Preposition. Muhammadan fast in the month of Ramzan. Something that they do. That is a verb. He keeps the fast for a week. Here it is a noun. He is on the committee. On is a preposition. Let us move on. Here on is a verb. Sit down and rest a while for some time. Here it is an adjective. I will watch while you sleep. This here it's a verb. They while away their evenings with books and games. Here it is a noun. Nouns and kinds of noun. A noun is a word used as a name of a person, place or thing. The word thing is used to mean anything that we can think of. Look at the following sentences. Ashoka was a wise king. The noun Ashoka refers to a particular king, but the noun king might be applied to any other king as well as to Ashoka. We call Ashoka a proper noun and king a common noun. Definition of a common noun is, a common noun is a name given in common to every person or thing of the same class or kind. Common here means shared by all. A proper noun, definition of a proper noun. A proper noun is the name of some particular person or place and it means one's own. Hence a proper name is a person's own name. Note, proper nouns are always written with a capital letter at the beginning. Note 2, proper nouns are sometimes used as common nouns as he was the Lukman, the wisest man of his age. Kalidas is often called the Shakespeare, the greatest dramatist of India. Common nouns include what are called collective nouns and abstract nouns. Now, a collective noun is the name of a number or collection of a person or things taken together and spoken of as one whole, or one word used for a number of people is a collective noun. Crowd, mob, team, flock, herd, army, fleet, jury, family, nation, parliament, committee. A fleet, a collection of ships or vessels. An army, a collection of soldiers. A crowd, a collection of people. The police dispersed the crowd. The French army was defeated at Waterloo. The jury found the prisoner guilty. A herd of cattle is passing. An abstract noun is usually the name of quality, action or state considered apart from the object to which it belongs, as quality, goodness, kindness, whiteness, darkness, hardness, brightness, honesty, wisdom, bravery. Action, laughter, theft, movement, judgment, hatred. State, childhood, boyhood, youth, slavery, sleep, sickness, death, poverty. The names of the arts and science, for example, grammar, music, chemistry, etc. are also abstract nouns. We can speak of a brave soldier, a strong man, beautiful flower, बट वी कैन ऑल्सो थिंक ऑफ दीज क्वालिटीज अपार्ट फ्रॉम एनी पर्टिकुलर पर्सन और थिंग एंड स्पीक ऑफ हैवी स्ट्रेंथ ब्यूटी बाय देमसेल्व्स. सो ऑल्सो वी कैन स्पीक ऑफ दैट वॉट पर्सन डू और फील अपार्ट फ्रॉम द पर्सन देमसेल्व्स एंड गिव इट अ नेम. द वर्ड एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मीन्स ड्रॉन ऑफ. Abstract nouns are formed from adjectives as kindness from kind, honesty from honest. Most abstract nouns are formed thus from verbs as obedience from obey, growth from grow. From common nouns is childhood from child, slavery from slave. Now the next exercise is exercise 2, page number 12. Point out nouns in the following sentences and say whether they are common, proper, collective or abstract. The crowd was very big. Crowd is a collective noun. Always speak the truth. Truth is abstract noun. We all love honesty. Honesty is abstract noun. Our class consists of 20 pupils. Class is a collection of students. Here it is a collective noun. The elephant has great strength. Elephant is a common noun and strength is an abstract noun. Solomon was famous for his wisdom. Solomon is proper noun and wisdom is abstract noun. Cleanliness is next to godliness. Cleanliness and godliness both are abstract nouns. He saw a fleet of ships in the harbor. Fleet is the collective noun. The class is studying grammar. Class is a collective noun. The Nile overflows its banks every year. Nile is a proper noun. A committee of 5 was appointed. Committee is collective noun. Nelson is famous for victory at Trafalgar. Nelson and Trafalgar are both proper nouns. The soldiers were rewarded for their bravery. Soldiers is common noun. Bravery is abstract noun. Without health, there is no happiness. Health and happiness are abstract nouns. He gave me a bunch of grapes. Bunch is collective noun and grapes are common noun. I recognized your voice at once. Your voice, anyone's voice is a common noun. Wisdom is better than strength. Wisdom and strength both are abstract nouns. Never tell a lie. Lie is an abstract noun. I believe in his innocence. Innocence is again an abstract noun. He sets a high value on his time. Time and value both are abstract nouns. I believe in his innocence. Innocence is abstract. The room is 30 feet in length. The room is a common noun. I often think of the happy days of childhood. Happy days of childhood. Childhood is your abstract noun. The streets of some of the cities are noted for their crookedness. Streets are common nouns. What is your verdict, gentlemen of the jury? Jury is a collective noun. Gentleman is common noun and verdict is abstract noun. Objects without life are often personified, that is spoken of as they were living beings, then regard them as males or females, the masculine gender, the feminine gender. The masculine gender is often applied to objects remarkable for strength and violence. The sun, the summer, winter, time, death. The sun sheds its beams, his beams on rich and poor alike. The feminine gender is often applied to objects remarkable for beauty, gentleness, gracefulness, etc. The moon, the earth, spring, autumn, nature, liberty, justice, mercy, peace, hope, and charity. The moon has hidden her face behind a cloud. Spring has spread her mantle of green over the earth. Peace hath her victories no less renowned than war. This use is most common in poetry, but certain nouns are personified in prose also. A ship is always spoken of as she. The ship lost all her boats in the storm. Ways of forming masculine and feminine form. By using an entirely different word, masculine, bachelor, maid, boy, girl. Masculine, feminine are bachelor, maid, boy, girl, brother, sister, buck, doe, bull or ox, cow, bullock, heifer, cock, hen, colt, filly, dog, bitch, drake, duck, drone, bee, earl, countess, father, mother, gander, goose, gentleman, lady, hart, roe, horse, mare, husband, wife, king, queen, lord, lady, man, woman, monk, nun, nephew, niece, papa, mama, ram, ewe, sir, madam, son, daughter, stag, hind, uncle, aunt, wizard, witch. There are more on this page also by adding a syllable. Author, authoress, baron, baroness, count, countess, giant, giantess, heir, heiress, host, hostess, Jew, Jewess, lion, lioness, manager, manageress, mayor, mayoress, patron, patroness, peer, peeress, poet, poetess, priest, priestess, प्रॉफिट प्रॉफिटेस, स्टूअर्ड स्टूअर्डेस, शेपर्ड शेपर्डेस।